Good evening from the Channel's newsroom here in London. Yemen has been hit with a series of airstrikes, with the Saudi-led coalition targeting sites in the capital Sana'a. At least six people, including four children, were killed and dozens of others were injured. An unequivocal response. 9 military sites in and around the capital were targeted, but these are the people suffering most. Emergency teams desperately searching for survivors, families already struggling, now facing new traumas. The airstrikes came just days after Iran-backed Houthi rebels launched a drone attack on Saudi Arabian vessels. Four ships were hit, two of them oil tankers. With the US and Saudis accusing Iran of ordering the attacks, there are fears the situation could continue to escalate.
There are alarming signs of the war, and war has a habit of trumping peace. Its impact more corrosive than the positive effect of hard-won gains towards ending wars.
Without diplomatic improvements, this is the likely result. Everyday people continuing to suffer as the four-year war takes yet more lives. President Trump has declared a national emergency. He's signed an executive order barring US companies from using foreign telecoms equipment made by firms that pose a national security risk. While Huawei isn't named, the Chinese tech giant is thought to be the target. A separate action saw the company and 70 others affiliated with it added to a blacklist, preventing them from acquiring components from American firms without government approval.
The relationship I have with President Xi is extraordinary. It's really very good, but he's for China and I'm for the USA, and it's very simple. If they want to make a deal, it could absolutely happen, but in the meantime, a lot of money is being made by the United States.
美方霸凌主义、极端施压的做法违背多边贸易规则，中方对此坚决反对。如果美方一意孤行， 中方将不得不做出必要反应。
The New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio has announced he's running for president. He joins a crowded field of Democrats. More than 20 have now officially declared their candidacy for the 2020 election. The 58-year-old released a video saying President Trump must be stopped.
I'm a New Yorker. I've known Trump's a bully for a long time. This is not news to me or anyone else here. Don't back down in the face of a bully. Confront him. Take him on. Donald Trump must be stopped. I've beaten him before, and I will do it again.
The British Prime Minister, Theresa May, is under growing pressure to stand down, and there's already a queue forming to replace her. The former Foreign Secretary, Boris Johnson, says he will run for the Conservative Party leadership when there's a vacancy. Theresa May has promised to resign if Parliament ratifies her Brexit deal. She survived a no-confidence vote last year, which means she can't be removed from office until December this year.
We have agreed to meet to decide the timetable for the election of a new leader of the Conservative Party as soon as the second reading has occurred, and that will take place regardless of what the vote is.
Sudan's military leaders have suspended political talks for 3 days. The Transitional Military Council has accused demonstrators of disrupting the process and life in the capital. Shots were fired as soldiers tried to remove barricades and clear the area. At least 9 people were reportedly injured. The head of the TMC says an agreement was reached with protest leaders for action to be de-escalated during negotiations, and they're now violating that understanding. He's demanding roadblocks be cleared, but demonstrators are refusing to back down until a civilian government is in place. A former leader of the Basque terrorist group ETA has been arrested in France. Josu Ternia had been on the run for more than 16 years. He's accused of ordering an attack on police barracks in the city of Zaragoza, which killed 11 people, including 6 children, in 1987. And finally, the catch of the day. Mesmerizing drone footage has been recorded showing a school of cow nose rays swimming off Bondi Beach in Sydney, off the southeast coast of Australia. The rare event was captured by Drone Shark app, which says it's unusual to see the marine animals that far south, and it's not seen anything like it in the 2 years it's been filming in the area. And that's your international news around the world in 5.